हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ सौम्या सुनील मडगांवकर, स्टडिंग इन बीएड फर्स्ट ईयर एट केएलई सोसाइटीज कॉलेज ऑफ एजुकेशन अंकोला। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट अ टॉपिक मैटर इन आवर सराउंडिंग्स। सब्जेक्ट साइंस केमिस्ट्री, क्लास 9th स्टैंडर्ड। लुक एट आवर सराउंडिंग्स, वी सी अ लार्ज वैरायटी ऑफ थिंग्स विद डिफरेंट शेप्स, साइज एंड टेक्सचर्स। एवरीथिंग इन दिस यूनिवर्स इज मेड अप ऑफ मटेरियल विच साइंटिस्ट हैव नेम्ड मैटर। द एयर वी ब्रीथ, द फूड वी ईट, स्टोन्स, क्लाउड्स, स्टार्स, प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल्स, इवन अ स्मॉल ड्रॉप ऑफ वाटर और अ पार्टिकल ऑफ सैंड, एवरीथिंग इज मैटर। नाउ लेट अस नो द मीनिंग ऑफ द मैटर। वॉट इज मैटर? Anything which has mass, which occupies space, is called matter. Let us know the physical nature of matter. Matter is made up of particles. There is a small experiment regarding to nature of matter. Take a 100 ml beaker, fill the half the beaker with water and mark the level of water. Dissolve some salt with the help of a glass rod. Observe any change in water level. It will be observed that salt disappears after being added to water. However, there is no change in the level of water in the beaker. When we dissolve salt in water, the particles of salt get into the spaces between particles of water. Therefore, matter is made up of particles. How small are these particles of matter? The particles of matter are very small. They are small beyond our imagination. There is an experiment regarding to size of the particles. Take 2-3 crystals of potassium permanganate and dissolve them in 100 ml of water. Take out approximately 10 ml of this solution and put it into 90 ml of clear water. Take out 10 ml of this solution and put it onto another 90 ml of clear water. Keep diluting the solution like this 5 to 8 minutes. This experiment shows that just a few crystals of potassium permanganate can color a large volume of water. So we conclude that there must be millions of tiny particles in just one crystal of potassium permanganate, which keep on dividing themselves into smaller and smaller particles. Characteristics of particles of matter. Particles of matter have space between them. Particles of sugar, salt, Dettol or potassium permanganate got evenly distributed in water. Particles of want of matter get into spaces between particles of other. This shows that there is enough space between particles of matter. Particles of matter are continuously moving. Particles of matter are continuously moving, that is, they possess what we call the kinetic energy. As the temperature rises, particles move faster. So we can say that with the increase in temperature, the kinetic energy of the particles also increases. There is a small experiment or example about how particles are continuously moving. Take glasses or beakers filled with water, put a drop of blue or red ink slowly and carefully along the sides of the beaker. Leave them undistributed. In here, what happens? Ink particles are moved continuously and color of water changes into blue. Particles of matter attract each other. For example, there is a piece of chalk piece. Here, the substance of the particles are held together with great force. Particles of matter have force acting between them. These force keep the particles together. The strength of this force of attraction varies from one kind of matter to another. States of matter. There are three states of matter: solid state, liquid state and gaseous state. Solid state. Properties of solid state. It has definite shape and definite volume. Molecules are tightly packed and arranged in a fixed position. It has tendency to maintain their shape when subjected to outside force. Solids are rigid in nature. It has very less compressibility and solids cannot flow easily. There are many examples of solid states. Stones. Stones are having definite shape and definite volume and hard in nature.
Rubber band, can it change its shape on stretching? No. A rubber band changes shape under force and regains the same shape when the force is removed. If excessive force is applied, it breaks. Sponges. A sponge has minute holes in which air is trapped. When we press it, the air is expelled out and we are able to compress it. Liquid state properties. Liquid has no definite shape but a fixed volume. Molecules are loosely packed in the liquid state. It has little high compressibility than solid state. It is not rigid but can be called fluid. It can flow easily. The best example for the liquid is water. Water has no definite shape but have a fixed volume. River. Here, water can flow easily. It is not rigid but can be called fluid. Look at the bucket is filled with water. Here, water has no definite shape. It occupies the shape of the bucket. Gaseous state properties. It have no definite shape and volume but completely fill the container that holds them. It has very high compressibility compared to solid and liquid. Gases flow more easily than liquid state. Space between gas particles are greatest and molecules move easily. Gaseous particles are continuous, random in motion. Examples of gaseous state are oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide, etc. There is small activity on this gaseous state. Take 100 ml syringe and close their nozzle by rubber corks as shown in the figure. Remove the pistons from all the syringes, leaving one syringe untouched. Fill the water in the second and pieces of chalk in the third. Insert the pistons back into the syringes. You may apply some Vaseline on the pistons before inserting them into syringes for the smooth movement. Now try to compress the content by pushing the piston in each syringe. Here we have observed that gases are highly compressible as compared to solids and liquids. The liquefied petroleum gas cylinder that we get in our home for cooking or the oxygen supplied to the hospitals in cylinders is compressed gas. Compressed natural gas is used as fuel these days in vehicles. Due to its high compressibility, large volumes of a gas can be compressed into smaller cylinder and transported easily. Look at this picture. We come to know of what is being cooked in the kitchen without even entering there by the smell that reaches our nostrils. How does this smell reaches? The particles of the aroma of food mix with the particles of air spread from the kitchen, reach us and even farther away. Can matter change its shape? Okay, let's see how matter can change its shape. Here water is an matter. Here water is exist in three forms. That is, solid as ice, liquid as water, gas as water vapor. Effect of change of temperature. A. Conversion of ice to water. Here a small experiment regarding how matter affect change in temperature. Take about 150 gram of ice in a beaker and suspend a laboratory thermometer so that its bulb is in contact with the ice. Start heating the beaker on a low flame. Note the temperature when the ice starts melting and also note the temperature when all the ice has converted into water. On increasing the temperature of solids, the kinetic energy of the particles also increases. Due to the increase in kinetic energy, the particles start vibrating with greater speed. The energy supplied by heat overcomes the force of attraction between the particles. The particles leave their fixed positions and start moving freely. The stage is reached when the solid melts and is converted into the liquid. What is melting point? The temperature at which a solid melts to become a liquid at the atmospheric pressure is called melting point. The melting point of ice is 273.16 Kelvin. B. Conversion of water into water vapors. It is similar as first experiment. Take water in a beaker and start heating. When we supply heat energy to water particles, start moving even faster. At a certain temperature, a point is reached when the particles have enough energy to break free from the forces of attraction of each other. What is boiling point? The temperature at which a liquid starts boiling at the atmospheric pressure is known as boiling point. Boiling is a bulk phenomenon. Particles from the bulk of the liquid gain enough energy to change into the vapor state. Boiling point of water is 373 Kelvin. Do you know what is sublimation? A change of state directly from solid to gas without changing into liquid state is called sublimation. For example, sublimation of ammonium chloride. Effect of change of pressure. How matter affect on change of pressure? Here small activity regarding this. When we apply pressure and compress a gas enclosed cylinder, here what happens? By applying pressure, the particles of matter can be brought close together. By applying pressure, solids can be converted into liquid. Further applying more pressure, liquids get converted into gaseous state. Here an image of interconversion of three states of matter. Look at the picture, how solids, liquids and gases are interconnected each other. Evaporation. The phenomenon of change of liquid into vapors at any temperature below its boiling point is called evaporation. There are many factors which affects the evaporation. In that, first one, an increase of surface area. We know that evaporation is a surface phenomenon. If the surface area is increased, the rate of evaporation is also increases. For example, while putting clothes for drying up, we spread them out. Second one, an increase of temperature. With the increase of temperature, more number of particles get enough kinetic energy to go into the vapor state. So, increase in the temperature is also causes the effects in the evaporation. Third one, a decrease in humidity. Humidity is the amount of water vapor present in air. The air around us cannot hold more than a definite amount of water vapor at a given temperature. If the amount of water in air is already high, the rate of evaporation decreases. Fourth one, an increase in wind speed. It is common observation that clothes dry faster on a windy day. With increase in wind speed, the particles of water vapor move away with the wind, decreasing the amount of water vapor in the surrounding. How does evaporation cause cooling? In an open vessel, the liquid keeps on evaporating. The particles of liquid absorb energy from the surrounding to regain the energy lost during evaporation. This absorption of energy from the surroundings make the surroundings cold, as you seen in the picture. Ice cold water in a bottle. Soon we will see water droplets on the outer surface of the bottle. The water vapor present in air on coming in contact with the cold glass of water loses energy and gets converted to liquid state, which we see as water droplet as seen in the picture.
Thank you for watching video.